with us and for attending tonight's post-game press conference. With us, head coach Angus Eve of the Trinidad and Tobago men's team. 3-1 victory over St Vincent, and he's going to open the remark and then we open the vote of questions. 4-1 victory over St Vincent. 4-1, and Angus, how you felt about it?
Good. When you can win 4-1 at home, and I think this score can easily end up about 10-11, the amount of chances we had, you have to give the goalkeeper a lot of credit. But I thought that we missed a lot of easy chances to kill off the game a lot earlier.
Opening question.
Yeah, coach. You know, you said that you want this team to play a certain brand of football, counter-attacking. You indicated at times. The football is sorted tonight. Is that close to where you want this team to be?
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the chances that we create on the counter-attack, I mean, it's evident to see how much chances we had on goal tonight. And the guys, we play what we see, and then we play on the break because we are very quick players. So yeah, if you watch the game tonight, we should have been easily about 10 goals today.
From my observation tonight, coach, I would say that the team started, you know, much sharper. And the first 20 minutes or so, we created a number of chances. So was that confidence overflowing from the St. Vincent game, or is this something that you've been seeing, you know, coming all the time?
Well, no, we've been starting fast. If you check all the games that we played, we would have scored very early in all of the matches that we played. So we come out the blocks very, very fast. And then we have a little bit of lull, which is when you go up that early, it have a little bit of lull, and then we had to pick back up ourselves again. So we have to maintain our consistency throughout the game for the 90 minutes. And this is part of the project, to get them to do that. We had two clean sheets in the day, and we were very disappointed to be scored upon today.
Playing St Vincent last week, what from that game that you planned to work on, that you learned to play against them last week?
Well, we learned exactly what they, you know, we were prepared for them, the pace that they had up front. You know, I think the strength of that team is also that they decide to sit back deep and then play on the break, and they come very fast. They try to press when we play 1, 2, 3 at the back. They then try to press the ball, and so we were breaking the lines. Because we worked on it after we saw what they were doing last week.
All right. After the first half beating 3-1, what was the mindset coming into the second half?
It's very difficult to motivate. See, world football, they tell you, the worst lead to have is 2-0, and we were 3-2, so it's the same scoreline. It's difficult. Players drop the intensity a little bit because they get a little bit relaxed. And then, fortunately, we made some changes, and then we picked back up in the end again and probably should have scored another 5 goals late in the second half.
How do you assess the campaign so far in the league?
Consistent. I think we've been consistent. You know, we started really badly, losing the game to Nicaragua, and then we had to dig ourselves out of a hole. I think we've done that successfully so far. I think Nicaragua is going to lead us going into the last 2 games by 1 point, which makes it basically in our hands because we are treating each game that we play as a fight.
Okay. Coach, on Noah Powder, he's a player who can play multiple positions, left back, right back. You even see him in central midfield for you. The last couple of games he's playing more like a winger. What do you say about his role in the team and also his performance tonight?
We have a lot of players that are multifaceted, a lot of players who can play different positions. And as I said before, when you're in a country like ours, we don't have a big cadre of international players who can play at this level. You have to maximize the players that you actually have. And Noah is one of these players who can, he plays striker for his team in the last couple of games. So he definitely can play anywhere in the park.
Alright, coach, last thing for me. Now you have a break, I could say, to the CONCACAF Nations League, with the 2 games being in March next year. What's the plan from now till then to, with this group?
Well, the guys will go back to their clubs, obviously. And, you know, we monitor them. It's going to be a little bit difficult for us because a lot of our players are based in the United States. And in March next year, the league don't start until about April. So we have a difficult task to try to get the players to be match fit in time for those matches. It baffles me why we can finish the next 2 games in September, in the next window, while everybody is fresh and everything is going on for all the teams, and the competition is still in our minds. I don't understand the big layoff. I think that we should have just played in September in the next window and finish off the last two games.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck in the rest of the game.